So with the new product lines that we did refresh our thermal solutions, right? So the way that we're doing it is we have upgraded the fan. Yeah. So before it was 4 volts, right now it's 12 volts. Right. So right now you have higher peaks and you got more horsepower going to your van, your fan, and also we actually do have a renewed design in terms of the heat pipes and the layout of a thermal solution inside. And other than that, you know, something on the side to prolong the product's life, we now have bring our patented a dust release architecture of fans from other products and tell to more product lines, including the brand new Strix. So yes, we do have new thermal designs to take on various different loadings and various different scenarios. For the GPU, we have covered a fairly wide range of GPUs in our product line. So we have something that ranges from GDX 1080 to GDX 1050. And we also have alternative lines that uses the Max Q architecture.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think we cover a good range of the graphics power, depending on, you know, different, I won't say budget, because we are not designed based on budget, but based on scenarios.
Yeah, really,
so if you want thin ones, we have powerful thin ones and mainstream thin ones. If you're okay with the traditional sizes, we have super powerful one, and we'll also have a little more mainstream one. So in terms of GPU, I think we covered a good range for different types of demand. And with some CPUs, I think right now we have a very good coverage in the high-end CPUs, including, well, we were one of the first partners with Intel on i9, right? So, and especially i9. I mean, that's the core essence of ROG, right? Getting the best out of the industry and squeeze the most out of it, right? So we have that. But in some segments, we are trying to see if we should offer a more mainstream solutions. But for ROG, I think we're still mostly going to cap it at higher end of the CPU, but we do have the product line within ASUS, so the ASUS Tough Gaming. So this serves a different type of target audiences, where their demands are a little different than, you know, what you would have imagined the ROG user. So in that respect, we would have a Core i5 that would be just, you know, adequate for whatever their demand is, to pair with a pretty good GPU. So yes, we have these different mixtures in the product offering.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
So this kind of products is to fit into the demand of user. They want to bring their gaming PC into their living room, enjoying the so-called immersive gaming environment. Okay, for example, you know, traditionally people may play with 27-inch or 32-inch. Definitely that kind of bigger size screen is good, but how about the racing game, right? So you definitely want to see different road, right? The curve, the U-turn, right? This kind of this and that. So definitely the bigger size will give you the wider view angle. Yeah, so we do think when people like to enjoy this kind of environment, they do need the bigger screen size.
We haven't have the specific number yet. But, actually it's like 20 degrees Celsius. Yeah, compared with if there's no fan, the standard AIO cooling.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because, you know, this is the same issues that we happened years ago. Yeah, we found when we want to overclock the X299 to CPU, But we found actually the CPU, the overclocking is limited by the VRM. Yeah, that's why we thought if we add a fan on it, then it probably can take the heat away. So yes, 20 degrees Celsius.
Oh, good. Yeah.
The new product line, actually, we have two SKU. And the first one, we call the Eugene. Mm-hmm. And Eugene, there is water cooling and plus a fan. Mm-hmm. And there's actually the fan just blow down to the VRM and also to the M.2 SSD area, the North Bridge area. Okay. So which is very, very helpful for is not only improve the CPU overclocking, but also the SSD performance. And we have another one is called RYUO. And RYUO, actually, there's no embedded fan here, but we feature, there's an OLED panel on the top. So which is very interesting. Actually, you can display many system information on it. Mm-hmm. Talking about if your CPU temperature, your motherboard information. Actually, there's a proprietary software. So we can using this OLED panel to display the overall system information. So this is others cannot do.
Okay, we are the newcomer of this power supply business. I have to be honest, the very first power supply, we did not start it from zero, but we study and co-work with many different current power supplier players to build these powerful power supplies. And also based on our very experienced, many experienced on motherboards, CPUs, graphic cards, GPUs, we know them very well. So that is why we decided to step in this industry. One of the reasons was because long time ago, the GPUs and CPUs, they were running at a constant clock. So the drawings were very stable. But nowadays, Nvidia and AMD has their boost clock, and Intel also have their boost technology. So the GPU and CPU now draws at a very, very fast speed. So now you do not just need a big power supply with 800 watts or 1200 watts. You will also need a fast power supply to respond to the very dynamic draws. And that is the reason why we decided to step in. The one that we're demonstrating right now are a 1200 watts one, and we will have an 850 watts very soon.